home is your podcast or your particular platform, and you keep doing your thing.
Sure.
But I think it's very important for people to remain subjective, opinionated, if they believe they're speaking from a substantiated point of view with facts. You know what I mean? So anyone who takes what I say, I'm not a personal guy, though. I think I've gone through so much in life.
Yeah.
It has made me very thoughtful. You know, I think before I say shit. You know, I think. And sometimes, like a Mengele or whatever, I didn't make that shit up. You know, like I said,
he's the one.
He extracted that verse of all his verses to explain the lyricism in his lyrics.
Sure.
You know? Yeah, of course, it was a bit animated, but it's literally what he said. You know what I mean? And I'm the same guy who, if I'm like, if you ask me, mention five guys who a guy from Kuwait would come to South Africa and he had to listen to. Vocalistic would still be there. Casper could be there, you know? And other of my favorite artists, and some I've said not so great things in particular aspects, you know what I mean? But generally, I respect their craft and what they do.
Yeah.
Sure. You know?
The mere fact you're speaking about them shows how much you pay attention to them.
Yeah,
of course.
Exactly. You know what I mean? Like, I don't do what I do to hurt guys or get to guys. I remember seeing a post, Vocalistic on his Insta Live, like, you podcasters.
Yeah,
Saul, you.
Yo, suicidal.
Man,
I didn't know that shit would get to him like that, bro.
I also didn't. You see how mad he looked, bro?
I don't like crushing
he
people.
He looked if he knew us, dog. Like, as if he knew us personally. Like, and I hate these guys now.
Bro, one thing I do not like to do is crush an African kid's dream.
Yeah.
You know? I don't. Yeah, I might clown you, but I'm thinking you're in the industry.
Yeah.
Your game.
Sure.
You, dude, look, so you're an icon or you're an aspiring icon. People will have opinions on you. Sure. You know?
Yeah.
And that's what I feel like. Even Casper, you know, like, bro, you're huge. You fill up stadiums. And Casper's got a massive following. Don't focus on the little people or a few people who say they're not
fucking
not
with
so good things about you. And when they do, try and understand where they come from. You know what I mean? But you can tell when, there's no facts here. Oh, okay, I see. Okay, I can see. You know what I mean? Like, if someone posts, I saw that wasn't your best show.
Sure.
You know, that wasn't your best performance. It wasn't your best day. Who were you today? You know what I mean? Deep, deep down inside, I know that today I didn't show up. I know.
Sure.
I can feel it. Or if I drop an episode of which one is, I can feel it.
Sure.
Inside. And a lot of times I even dread reading the comments. I don't even go.
When I feel
like I didn't do well, I don't go.
I mean, even if I think I did well.
I know myself. Shit gets to me and I want to respond. You know what I mean? So when you have a better self-understanding of that, you stay away from it. So I feel like guys are so big and so talented. They do crazy numbers. Don't care what Saul says.
Sure.
And if you do, understand where I'm coming from. Am I lying? Yes, no. Am I embellishing the truth? Yes, no. You decide. But it would never be unsubstantiated.
Yeah.
Sure. I'll never just purely hate someone.
Mm.
Like, there's no one now you can say, Saul hates this character in the game, you know? So I feel like if people are matured enough, I could still do my things in the game without anyone feeling like, fuck him, I'm blacklisting him.
You know what I mean?
So have you spoken or talked to Voka?
No, I haven't. And funny thing is, if I see him at an event, I'll greet him, you know?
Mm.
Test the waters. If he's like, fuck you,
sure,
you know what I mean? It's fine. We're not going to mingle or mingle.
Or mingle.
Mengele. Mengele, mengele.
Yeah, you know,
because
you
go to Spetele, Spetele.
You won't show me hospitality, but you'll show me hospital. So, like, I try to greet him because what I said was not coming from a hateful place, personally.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It was coming from a professional place. And to say, like, you know, I didn't think that thing would be that big. Yeah. You know what I mean? It was fucking funny, yo. So happy.
It was hilarious.
So even yesterday when I posted that his trailer, and you go to his Twitter page, you'll find it.
Mm.
You know, was fucking amazing. Someone came, like, and I blocked that person. Like, yeah, you are changing now, whatever. You hate this guy. I'm like, dog, when did I say I fucking hate this guy?
Mm.
You know what I mean? And when he dropped this song, my vendor, I was like, a dope song. And you know what I mean? And even the Mengele song is dope. You know, it's just that when he said it's...
his best verse, basically.
Or, yeah, it's a verse he can showcase as his skills of lyricism.
Sure.
You know? I was like, dude, fuck you. I was not going to respond to that. I blocked the guy, you know?
Mm.
And another one came on as well, like, ah, Mick G took you out of nowhere, whatever, whatever. Yo, yeah, dog, I wasn't trying to... like, I'm like, dude, I wasn't trying to knock into the game. Mm. I was happy with my life where I am and where I'm going. I can provide for my kid. And keep the lights on. I was never looking to come back into the game. You know, I remember I got a friend who's been saying, yo, radio this. I tried to like submit demos in radio.
Mm.
And as a person, not even a person who has worked in the game, but just as a person applying for a job, you know, treat me with some respect, dignity.
Mm.
You know, I can't talk to you now. Call me later. When you call, it's like, I think I saw your thing. Nothing. Yeah, you know.
Sure.
Like, oh, did that for three, four times. I'm like, fuck this shit.
Yeah.
I told my friend, like, listen, bro. People know my work. They know where to find me if they want me.
Mm.
You know what I mean? So like, I'm not really one to crush people for trying and for doing their shit. I'm not like that, at all.
Yeah.
So,
I wanna to know, since you were like, you know, in radio for a while, do you think Payola will ever stop?
I don't, dog.
That everything was, is payola.
That shit was around before we were born.
Yeah.
And I'm
the
oldest one here. I think I'm guaranteed I am.
I do.
You know, that shit was around in the 60s, 50s in the US. Shit is not going anywhere. As long as there's greed and there's one person who the buck stops with who says this song can or cannot play, I don't think so. When I was at YFM, there was a good system. It's called a music committee. I don't know if it's still there now, but everybody links up, the compiler, program manager, and anyone in the staff, from your finance guy to your interns to your salespeople to your news people, they put their hats, their names into the hat to say, I want to be part of this thing.
Yeah.
Put their names forward. And you've got a group of 12 people who all listen to all the submissions. They vote on them, and all the songs that have voted yes go onto the playlist.
Mm.
So like that, there's no one holding the golden key to unlock the door of playlisting. You know what I mean? So, and I think if a lot of people follow that
model,
that model, we can then have less payola. Because now, anyone in the music committee hears a song, they're like, wait, I didn't hear that song last week in the music committee. How did it get in?
Sure.
You get what I mean?
Yeah.
So I think if radio stations are open,
they need better systems.
Yeah, exactly. About their systems, especially the music policy, we could erode a lot of the payola away.
Yeah.
But as long as there's somebody willing to pay.
Also, right? It's like bribes for jobs, right? When you fight those.
How do you bribe and you want a job? Where's the money coming from?
Yo, guys take loans. Guys' mothers take loans. Guys' girlfriends take loans. Guys' friends. People steal for anything. You know what I mean?
Sure.
Like, it's like that. Or any other form of corruption.
Mm.
You can't fight the beneficiary without fighting the giver.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You need to also, like, if there's a willing buyer, if there's a willing seller, there's a willing buyer. So you need to fight the buyer as well. But you're right. Mm. And there'll always be people with deep pockets, B.
Yeah.
Sadly. I saw some guy on Facebook, I forgot his name. I was on his thing this week. They're forming a committee to fight payola. Flip, I forgot. I remember Sipos Tole commented. Because the guy rode in caps and Sipos Tole was like, it's very difficult to read capital letters. And the guy then translated the whole thing in normal cases. And the guys were like, yeah, what now? And, you know, there was no response. But I remember there's people like forming a committee and whatnot to fight all of that.
Sure.
Because not everyone can keep up, dog. Not everyone. I won't say names, has deep pockets.
Mm. Yeah.
You know, not everyone. Yeah.
Sure. I know. I think that's been the part, bro. Yo, Sol. Thank you so much, brother.
You'd say one thing, I just go on.
Yeah.
But you will cover everything.
Yeah, we clocked like 2 hours.
Yeah, dude, we spoke.
Oh, you wanna hit the exclusive?
Did we talk about everything you guys had in mind?
Yeah, no, we did.
Like we did. You're so used to podcasting. Are you guys settled? I said what I had to say.
Sorry, man, for not crediting you guys, man.
Nah, like, no stress, dog. Like,
it's just a pity you can't say
you
exactly.
Nah,
you know?
nah.
I still think maybe fuck all I heard that, from dog. Somewhere
nah,
else.
Fuck that shit, dog.
I'm sorry.
I don't even care. Listen, you're one of the realest out here, bro.
Yeah, man. Thank you for supporting us. Let's push this thing and let's push it to the fucking max.
Like, yo, we appreciate it.
And do this thing. I love what you guys are doing, man.
Thank you so much, bro. Thank you for coming through.
You're fucking bold, dog.
Bravest guy in SA.
Yeah, I love it, man. You like the balance and, you know. You guys are great, man. Yeah. Thank you guys, man. You know, love what you guys are doing.
We're gonna end it up with like an exclusive. Izolo.
Nah, he said he didn't.
Izolo, it was Reason.
Yeah.
Today it's KO.
But KO said he didn't.
Tomorrow.
But KO denied it.
Yeah, he tweeted that he didn't.
Because I saw a tweet by Kelly Wonga. You saw the tweet?
Yeah, I saw it.
Kelly Wonga was the white guy around telling people he wrote verses in it right.
Sure.
And I thought there was a Nizolo. He could have been talking about something else, though.
But I knew KO didn't. That was like, there's no way.
That didn't sound like KO, bro.
Yeah,
like,
bro. No,
but KO could do it, though. I was like, he could. You don't think you... Like, I feel like you could Kijima like that, you know?
No,
in Venek, on a piano beat.
But he's always on Venek. He doesn't run like that. He's a god.
Have you actually heard his new song with Ma'i? That one, yeah. They're Kijiming, yeah.
Mm.
For real. You must check it out.
But he denied it.
Shout out to the big homie.
Yo.
Thank you so much for pulling through, bro.
Time, my nigga.
Steph, Dintang, Fitz, we're the show.
Away, dog.
Away.
He's always like, show. Hey, what's the plan is this one?
Is it nice?
Oh.
Nice one.
Guys, that was beautiful.
So you are a professional broadcaster. You survived.
Guys, man, lovely work. You know, keep doing this thing. Let's keep doing it. Let's keep going.
Who's this?
Manjo and
Jesus.
Yeah.
So he left hip-hop. left hip-hop because people didn't appreciate his lyrics. People turn up piano and still get the same thing. Spiritual effect. Get into the rhythm was the one I said connect. Trying to hit the Kenny G spot.
Okay, now the reason is, all them high notes
when I enter. My hot sticks make a burnout when I smash. Do it for the money or you do it for the pleasure. Either way, I'm always going to be a chemist whiz. Take it slow and maybe do it faster. It doesn't matter cause I'm always on your tempo. Pull up to the bando. Ain't no Coltrane, it's just me and you on key. Tapping to the best tunes. Such a classic, I respect you. I just play along to impress you. I just hope you know I wrote this to address you. Cause I know when I'm with you.
I'm a fit, the chorus. See, this is why some pianos don't get shit played. Fucking split.